Welcome back to ajspeller.com. In today's video, we're going to learn about the characteristics of a circle. Let's begin by defining what a circle is. All right. A circle is a set of points that are equidistant, which really means the same distance, that are equidistant from a single point called the center. All right, in this particular example, we see that the center of this circle is labeled A, and that center is also the name that you would use when you're referencing the circle. All right, next let's talk about something called a chord. And you know what, let's switch it so we have some bullet points here. Next, a chord. A chord is a line segment that connects two points on the circle. All right, and let's take a look at an example here. So if I were to draw a chord, start here at this location and maybe go up to this location, and I'm going to actually explicitly show the points. So this here is a chord, and let's go ahead and label it. All right, we have another type of chord called a diameter. All right, so a diameter is a special chord that goes through the center of the circle and it also connects two points on the circle. Alright, and let's take a look at a drawing of that. So let's start with a point here. Let's make our way through the center of the circle here at A and end on the other side. I'm going to again explicitly draw in the points. Alright, this here is our diameter. And like I said earlier, a diameter is also a chord, just a special type of chord. All right, the next characteristic or part of a circle we want to talk about is a radius. All right, and a radius is a line segment that connects the center of the circle with a point on the circle. All right, let's draw that in. So let's start here with the center of the circle, and let's go out to a point on the circle. And again, I'm going to draw in the points here to show that. And this here is a radius. All right, the next characteristic I want to talk about is the circumference. All right. And circumference is the distance around a circle. All right, and let's just try to draw that in. Again, notice, you know, I'm freehanding, so it's not going to be perfect. But as we go around the circle, back to where we started, this distance here is called a circumference. All right, so we looked at analytically some of the characteristics. Now let's talk about some of the relationships between these characteristics that we pointed out. Alright, let's begin with diameter. So we have our diameter here. A diameter is equal to 2 times the radius. So diameter is equal to 2 times the radius. So let's try to make that clearer here. When I go from this point here on the circle to the center, that there is actually a radius. When I go from the center to this point in the circle, that there is also a radius. When I put those two radii together, they actually make a diameter. So the radius times 2 is going to give me a diameter. Next, let's take a look at the radius. All right, the radius is equal to the diameter divided by 2. This can also be said as 1/2 times the diameter. So again, if I'm looking at this diameter here and I cut this diameter in half, you'll see what I have left is just this segment here called a radius. All right, now let's talk about circumference. And remember, we said that circumference is the distance around the circle. All right, so the circumference is approximately the equal sign with the squigglies, or squiggly equal sign, that means approximately. So the circumference is approximately 3 times whatever the diameter is for that particular circle. Another way of looking at this equation here is to say that the circumference divided by the diameter is approximately 3. In some texts, you'll see it as also 22 over 7. So it could be approximately either or. All right, and as you get further into your studies of circles, you'll learn about something called pi. All right, and pi is a Greek letter. And pi is an irrational number, and that number is 3.1415926, and it continues on forever. So this here is the basics of the characteristics of a circle. Hopefully this made more sense and cleared up any questions that you may have. Thank you again for watching a video by ajspeller.com.